Hello friends and welcome back to my channel. So this is going to be a very short video wherein I will tell you what are the different topics from which dialogues can come and what are the passing and failing scenarios. Okay, there are basically three important scenarios that you need to keep in mind, okay, in order to decide whether a candidate has successfully passed the exam or has he failed it. Okay, so let's begin this dialogue, this particular video. So first we'll be looking into the topics, okay. First of all, I just want to mention here that the dialogues that come in NATI exam, they will reflect real life situations in Australian society. They are designed to evaluate a candidate's ability to understand both languages and communicate effectively in them. So basically you need to listen something in English and you need to translate it to the other language. And you have to do vice versa, listening in the other language and translating it in English. So it actually see like how efficient you are or whether you are equipped to do the job or not. Okay, so now we'll see what are the different topics. So first is business, consumer affairs, employment, health, immigration or settlement, then legal, then community, education, financial, housing, insurance, and social services. So this is the basic list of 12 sections from which dialogues can come. Okay, I have uploaded many videos, around 50 of them, which will cover each and everything. So I would request you to kindly go through this, through the dialogue videos, so that you can get practice on each of these topics. Now, for pass and fail, how to decide whether a candidate has passed or failed the examination. So ideally, the test comprises of two dialogues and each containing around 45 marks. So in order to pass the test, the candidate is required to obtain minimum 29 in each dialogue and has an overall score of minimum 63. These are the two conditions. Okay. Now I am just going to show you some scenarios and then we'll determine whether the candidate has passed or failed the exam. Okay, so as I was telling you, 29 in each dialogue and passes, like you need to, the total should be more than 63 or more than that. Marginal fail is when a candidate scores between 55 and 62.5, then he is, then in his report card it's mentioned as marginal fail, and it's a clear fail if the candidate has scored less than 55, okay. Or he has scored less than 29 in any one of the dialogue. Okay, the marginal fail is if he has scored more 29 in each of the dialogue, but his score did not reach 63, then he is considered as marginal fail. So don't worry, we will look at some scenarios, so you will get a better idea. So now this is the first situation. The dialogue one, in dialogue one, the candidate scored 29. In dialogue 2, the candidate scored 29. So according to the marking criteria of each dialogue, he has cleared both the dialogues, but his total score is 58 out of 90. As we said earlier, so the final result is he has marginally failed the exam, because even though he has scored the minimum required marks in each dialogue, but his total is not 63 yet. So he has marginally failed the exam. Now let's move to the second situation. In dialogue 1, he scored 30, and in dialogue 2, he has scored 33. So the total score is 63 out of 90. So the final result is pass, because he has scored 29 minimum in each dialogue and his overall score is also 63, which is the minimum required in order to clear the exam. So he has passed the exam. Now the situation 3, wherein in the dialogue 1 the candidate scores 40, which is very good score, okay, and in the dialogue 2 he scored 28. Okay, so the total score is 68. So here the candidate has clearly failed the exam, because the minimum marks that he needs to score in each dialogue is 29, but in the dialogue 2 he could not score 29, even though his total score is well above 63, but he has failed the exam because the minimum score required in each dialogue is 29. Okay, so this is the thing. And ideally, initially the results used to be sent to all the people who took the NATI exam within 2 to 4 weeks or 6 weeks. Now, as per the information that we have, it is the process is fast tracked, and some people have even reported getting the result in 1 or 2 business days. So it is a very good news for people who are taking the online exam, okay, because now you can get faster results and then you can start your pre-R process too. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. Kindly like the content if it helped you in some way, and if you want me to change something or you didn't like something, kindly put it in the comment section. Also subscribe to my channel, because I am putting regular videos which will definitely help you in your preparation or give you substantial knowledge. And then also kindly share my content with other NATI aspirants, because it is going to help. If you do so, it is going to help them and they will be thankful to you. Also kindly press the bell icon so that you do not miss any notifications, because I am uploading videos on a regular basis, almost daily. So it makes sense to subscribe to get a notification out of it. So thank you guys. Have a nice day. Bye bye.